If you want to advertise on Google and you haven't created a Google Ads campaign, the first thing you'll need to do is set up a Google Ads account. There are a few different options you can select, so I'll also share some expert tips you can use when you're setting up your account. The first thing you need to do is head to google.com/ads. And when you create a new account, I suggest checking out to see if Google is running any promotions or other offers for your location. We can see here they're currently offering $600 in advertising credit after you spend your first $600. So this can help you reach more prospects and customers as you're starting out. There's also an offer for free consulting to help you create your first campaign. We can click Expert Support at the top to see more details about this offer. I do need to highlight that these promotions and offers can change, so you might see something different when you head to the Google Ads website. Okay, the next thing you'll need to do is make sure you're logged into your Google account. This could be your Gmail address, your Google Workspace address, or the login you use for other Google products. So just make sure you're logged in using the email address and password you want to use to access your new Google Ads account. Now we click Start Now at the top. We're asked to provide some details about our business to create our first campaign. And I need to highlight that Google is always testing changes to Google Ads to make improvements. So the screen you see might be slightly different to this one. But don't worry, all of the information you need to provide will be the same. If you want to set up a new Google Ads account and you're ready to create a campaign, then you can click Create Your First Campaign and travel through the steps. However, I recommend you start by skipping the steps to create a campaign. I find this is a better approach because you'll be able to see all of the available options in Google Ads. You can spend extra time planning your campaign, and you'll have more time to get everything right before you start spending money to advertise your business. Setting up your account before creating campaigns is like laying the foundation for a house. If we started laying bricks before the foundation is ready, it might look okay, but it's not going to last long and it's not going to provide the structure we need. So we can click Skip Campaign Creation at the bottom. Or if you accidentally click something else, we can click Create an Account without a campaign. Now we need to select the country we want to use for billing, the time zone to use for our campaigns and reports, and the currency we will use to pay our advertising spend. When you're happy with the selections, click Continue. The next step is to confirm our payment details. Since I already have other active Google Ads accounts, it has pre-filled the organization name and the payment method. When you're on this step, you'll need to enter your payment details. Below this, we can choose if we want one of Google's experts to contact us to help with our new campaign, and if we want to receive other emails from Google Ads. Then we click Submit. We've now created our new Google Ads account. Let's click the button to check out our new account. Since we skipped the steps to create a new campaign, we can see our account is empty and Google Ads is suggesting we create a new campaign. I need to highlight there are two main versions of the Google Ads interface. There's a new version that Google is slowly rolling out, and there's the previous version. The new version has the menu on the left, while the previous version has the menu at the top. So you might find things are in slightly different places depending on the version you're using. If you'd like to learn more about the different versions, then I've included a link to a video explaining this in the description. For this new account, we're using the previous version of the interface, and I'm going to show you a couple of features and tools you can use. I'm going to show you where to find them in this version first, and then I'll show you in the new version. Whether you're using the new version or the old version, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel. Subscribing means you'll receive alerts when I release tutorials covering updates and changes to Google Ads. Okay, now let's select Tools and Settings. This shows us all the different tools and features we can use in our new account. There's a lot to learn if you're getting started, so I just want to mention a couple of things. First is the Keyword Planner. You can use this to research the different keywords people search for on Google. It's also useful because it provides an estimate of how much you'll need to spend when someone clicks on your ads. I also recommend you link your new Google Ads account to Google Analytics. To do this, you can select Linked Accounts. Then we select Google Analytics GA4. We can then see all of the Google Analytics properties we can access using our Google account, so the email address you use to log into Google. I have a lot of different Google Analytics properties, so I just need to find the property I want to use, and then click Link. I'm going to enable the option to use audiences, and then click Link. We've now linked Google Analytics to our new Google Ads account. Another feature you need to set up before launching your first campaign is conversion tracking. You can do this by selecting Tools and Settings, and then Conversions. You can then set up dedicated Google Ads conversion tracking or import conversions from Google Analytics. Since we just linked Google Analytics, let's import an existing conversion. To do this, let's create a new conversion. Now let's select Import and choose Google Analytics 4. Let's select Web and click Continue. We can now select the conversions we want to import and click Import and Continue. These conversion actions will now be tracked into Google Ads. This is super important because now we'll be able to use these for reporting on performance and optimizing our campaigns. Now let me show you where to find these tools and features in the new version of Google Ads. To do this, I'm going to switch to another one of my Google Ads accounts. We're now looking at the new version of Google Ads. To find the Keyword Planner in the new version, we select Tools, then Planning, and we can then find the Keyword Planner. To link Google Analytics, we select Admin, and then Linked Accounts. You can then follow the same steps we covered previously. And to configure conversions in the new version, we select Goals. We can then create conversions and import conversions from Google Analytics. Okay, now that you've created your new Google Ads account, the next steps are to decide what you're going to advertise, how much you want to spend on advertising, and how you're going to target your ads. For example, what keywords do you want people to be searching for when your ads appear? I cover all of this and more in my complete Google Ads tutorial. So when you're ready to create your campaign and you want to make sure it's set up correctly, make sure you check it out.